So our today's topic in maths is integers, and in maths we are starting a new lesson which is integers. Now before learning integers, let's learn a few things. First, let's learn that what are natural and whole numbers. So natural numbers, these are the set of numbers that are used to count objects in nature. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Now, after learning natural numbers, let's learn whole numbers. So, when we add 0 to the set of natural numbers, this new set of numbers is called whole numbers. So, natural numbers are the set of numbers that are used to count objects in nature. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And when we add 0, so these are the set of natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So when we add 0 to this set of natural numbers, we form a new set of numbers which are called whole numbers. Now, let's learn positive and negative numbers. Positive numbers are numbers which have a positive sign, that is plus before them. So they have a positive sign and the positive sign is plus. So they have a positive sign that is plus before them. For example, plus 5, plus 4, plus 3, plus 9, etc. So as we can see that all these examples have a positive sign, means plus before them. Positive numbers can also be written as 5, 6, 8, 1, 2, etc. So in these examples, if we remove this plus sign, then also they will remain positive numbers. Now negative numbers. Negative numbers are the numbers which have a negative sign before them. So these are the numbers which have a negative sign, which is minus before them. So the positive sign is plus and the negative sign is minus. So negative numbers have a negative sign which is minus before them. For example, minus 2, minus 1, minus 3, minus 9, minus 5, etc. Now let's learn the difference between positive and negative numbers. Now this is a table which explains the difference between positive and negative numbers. So the first difference, positive numbers have a positive sign before them and negative numbers, they have a negative sign before them. This is the first difference, that positive numbers have a positive sign, means plus before them, and negative numbers have a negative sign, means minus before them. Now positive numbers, they are always bigger than 0. So positive numbers, they are always bigger than 0. And negative numbers, they are always smaller than 0. So apart from positive numbers that are bigger than 0, negative numbers are smaller than 0. Positive numbers, for example, plus 5, plus 6, plus 7, plus 9, etc. Negative numbers, for example, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, etc. Now, after learning these things, now let's learn the definition of integers. So we have learned the basic things, now let's learn that what are integers. So what are integers? So when we combine the whole and negative numbers, we get a new set of numbers known as integers. So we study that what are whole numbers and negative numbers. So when we combine both these set of numbers, we get a new set of numbers which are called integers. Now, this is a number line which is showing the positive and negative numbers. It also shows the placement of the negative and positive numbers. The 0 is always in the center. So now this is a number line. And as we can see that 0 is always in the center. And on the right side of the 0, there are all the positive numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. And on the left side of 0, there are all the negative numbers. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, etc. So, whenever a number is on the right side of the number line, means on the right side of 0, it is a positive number. And whenever a number is on the left side of the number line, means on the left side of 0, it is always a negative number. Thank you.